It's a shell game, corporate America's hidden profit center.
The tax shelter business has become basically stealing from the Treasury.
Hide and seek against the IRS.
These were close to sham transactions. Some were clearly sham transactions.
When they didn't pay, the burden fell on us.
These guys are just complete freeloaders on the rest of us. They're paying a whole lot less than they used to, and the rest of us are picking up the tab for them.
You could double everybody's refund if you just collected all the taxes that are due.
Tonight on Frontline, correspondent Hedrick Smith follows the tax shelter trail to surprising places.
So this is human waste, chemical waste.
Uncovering the companies behind the tax schemes.
First Union, North Carolina.
Discovering how the schemes were sold.
And their response was, no, this is a clean deal. We're using the IRS laws against them.
And unveiling what's really going on inside America's biggest tax firms.
The elements of hiding the facts were really just blatant. At that point, I really realized some of the stuff that these guys are doing may very well be criminal.
Tonight on Frontline, the Great American Tax Dodge.
I read First Union had gotten about $1 billion in fast tax write-offs from a bunch of leasing deals, including that deal in Dortmund.
But as a CEO, you were certainly aware it was deliberate.
So I started to ask about the tax write-offs.
I don't know that I could have told you what it meant to our bottom line.
You make a $4 billion profit a year and something's delivering you $1 billion?
Well, Rick, if you're going to do an investigative report, let's change the subject.
Crutchfield said he was unprepared, had not been forewarned about discussing taxes.
Same subject, the interview's over.
And cut off the interview. I wrote Crutchfield, asking him to take time to prepare and do another interview. But Crutchfield would not talk to us, neither would the bank. So I went to see a watchdog on tax issues, Robert McIntyre, director of the Institute on Taxation and Economic Policy. He said First Union's tax benefits from leasing were huge.
Leasing was central to their tax sheltering strategy as far as their annual report reveals. From 1997 to 1998, First Union reports that it saved close to $1.5 billion in taxes from leasing. They were pretty aggressive at sheltering. That was enough to cut its tax rate in 1998 to only about 6%. It was almost, you know, down to nothing.
First Union had plenty of company. The bull market of the 90s was a spawning ground for a shelter epidemic that swept through corporate America. As profits soared, companies were finding ingenious ways to lose money, or appear to lose money.
I saw what was called corporate tax shelters grow in the 90s. And I realized, and other professionals like me realized, it was not what we used to think of as tax shelters in the days of old.
Former Reagan Treasury official Buck Chapatin was troubled by the new tax tricks.
These were a different animal. These were close to sham transactions. Some were clearly sham transactions. Had nothing to do with investment. They simply were financial mechanisms for creating losses, tax losses, no economic losses.
The increase in abusive shelters and use of legitimate deductions was fueling an even bigger trend, a sharp decline in corporate tax rates, according to public records.
Well, on paper, the corporate tax rate is 35%, but because there's so many loopholes, so many shelters, well, we did a study looking at companies through 1998, the 250 of the biggest. And their average rate by 1998 was 20%, not 35. And lately, we think the rate is down to about 15. In other words, companies are paying less than half of what they're supposed to.
Some companies paid zero taxes. Others even got tax rebates. And as the corporate tax payments plummeted, so did the corporate share of the total tax take.
From 1950 to 2000, corporations averaged about 17% of the federal taxes. And all of a sudden now, down to 7%. 7% of the government paid for by corporate taxes. So yeah, they're paying a whole lot less than they used to, and the rest of us are picking up the tab for it.
But Frontline has learned that the U.S. investor in Bochum Sewers was...
First Union is now Wachovia. Wachovia. An uncommon approach to banking.
Well, Wachovia, amazingly, in 2002, even though it reported $4 billion in profits, reported that it didn't pay any taxes and, in fact, got a tax rebate from the government of about $160 million.
How much were they actually writing off from leases at Wachovia?
Well, they said they saved $3 billion in taxes over the last 3 years from leasing, so huge write-offs.